I have heard talk of bold Robin Hood and of brave little John. A friar Tuck and Will Scarlet, Locksley and Maid Marian. But such a tale as this before, I think there was never none. For Robin Hood disguised himself, and to the wood is gone. Like to a friar, bold Robin Hood was accoutred in his array. With hood, gown, beads, and crucifix, he passed upon the way. He had not gone miles two or three, but it was his chance to spy two lusty priests clad all in black, come riding gallantly. Benedicite, said Robin Hood, some pity on me take. Cross you my hand with a silver groat for our dear lady's sake. For I've been wandering all this day, and nothing could I get. Not so much as one poor cup of drink, nor bit of bread to eat. Now by my holy dame, the priest replied, we never a penny have. For we this morning have been robbed, and could no money save. I am much afraid, said bold Robin Hood, that you both do tell a lie. And now before that you go hence, I am resolved to try. When as the priests heard him say so, they rode away amain. But Robin Hood betook him to his heels, and soon overtook them again. Then Robin Hood laid hold of them both and pulled them down from their horse. Oh, spare us, friar, the priest cried out, on us have some remorse. You said you had no money, quoth he, wherefore without delay we three will fall down on our knees, and for money we will pray. The priests, they could not him gainsay, but down they kneeled with speed. Send us, oh, send us, then, quoth they, some money to serve our need. The priests did pray with mournful cheer, sometimes their hands did wring. Sometimes they wept and cried aloud, whilst Robin did merrily sing. When they had been praying an hour's space, the priests did still lament. Then quoth bold Robin, now let's see what money heaven hath us sent. We will be sharers now all alike of the money that we have, and there is never a one of us that his fellows shall deceive. Priests their hands in their pockets put, but money would find none. We'll search ourselves, said Robin Hood, each other one by one. Then Robin Hood took pains to search them both, and he found good store of gold, 500 pieces presently upon the grass was told. Here is a brave show, said Robin Hood, such store of gold to see. And you shall each one have a part, 'cause you prayed so heartily. He gave them £50 apiece, and the rest for himself did keep. The priests durst not speak one word, but they sighed wondrous deep. With that the priests rose up from their knees, thinking to have parted so. Nay, stay, said Robin Hood, one thing more I have to say ere you go. You shall be sworn, said bold Robin Hood, upon this holy grass, that you will never tell lies again, which way soever you pass. The second oath that you here must take, all the days of your lives. You never shall tempt maids to sin, nor lie with other men's wives. The last oath you shall take it is this: be charitable to the poor. Say you have met with a holy friar, and I desire no more. He set them upon their horses again, and away then they did ride. And he returned to the merry greenwood with great joy, mirth, and pride.